first thing we can notice when we look at John Jones is that he's very tall and lanky. At closer glance, it's obvious. His greatest strength is his mind, which he firmly believes as well.
A lot of pride in our work at home. And knowing that, you know, that it's getting a whole trip, we can do that. I'm not a knock out of it. I want to be smart and smart and smart. And, you know, work hard.
His techniques don't deliver knockout force, nor are they perfect. With two things remaining consistent to his approach. An approach that heavily emphasizes an element of surprise whilst smashing the formal portions of his body, hence the nickname Bones. Side note, he also acknowledges this title because he acknowledges that he's skinny. He looks at patterns of behavior you refine his techniques, figures out why you use that technique, and tries to use it against you through his unique anatomy.
I study everybody extensively, and then I come up with a pattern. Figure out what influence to figure out their first favorite points of their setups, their influential setup that's going to be literally everything. I know everything about every opponent. What's that going to shoot? What's going to get inside and outside? What do I do about that? You know, I figure out everything. Why they shoot? What area of the cage they like to shoot? Everything.
I'm not trying to instantly KO you.
I'm not a knockout artist. I want to be smart.
But instead, methodically breaking you down until nothing is left. Let's look at a few examples of this. Alexander Gustafsson is taking a spinning elbow. He waits for the jab, and the moment John sees it coming, lowers his stance, blocks it with his shoulder, but also, from that lowered position, generates momentum for a spinning elbow, devastating Alexander, to which he follows up with a clenched knee. Just notice an element of unrefinedness to the way John strikes. John clearly is not a fighter who masters obliterating you with a signature move like Conor McGregor's counter punch, and this ironically communicates his greatest strength, that he does not have one strong move, and instead has an arsenal adapted specifically to you, exploiting your behaviors in your signature moves. Here's another example of John exploiting behavior. Look at the way Rashad guards by holding his hand out, looking at the chest area, hoping to mitigate any traditional punches or strikes coming in. John sees this and uses his unique anatomy to exploit this. Look at the way John's left hand traps Rashad's right hand, nullifying his capacity to raise his head and guard against a strike, with also an element of surprise in the strike due to its unorthodox nature. Absolutely genius. This is brilliant. When John feints into a spinning elbow, he has many feints to set it up, sometimes with a punch, but here, he creeps forward with his wrestling pressure and uses that position to explode into a very counterintuitive elbow. His opponent had no idea what just happened, and it lands clean. The last move I want to go over is his oblique kick or knee stomp versus Rampage. John knows Rampage is a fighter who likes to come in close and swing you into a concussion. His style, in that sense, is very unidimensional, but nonetheless, due to its power, very dangerous. John understood and respected this, and basically tried to avoid staying in that pocket with Rampage at all costs, even running away in certain instances. But in order to keep a distance, another move he used was through his lanky anatomy, the knee stomp. Every time Rampage would slowly try to come in, this was the technique John would use, exploiting the fact Rampage is very unidimensional. He doesn't have insane footwork, he doesn't want to take you down, the only thing he wants to do is come up and bang hands. To which, this move is absolutely perfect, hyperextending the knee, causing damage to the ligaments, reducing overall tension power whilst creating hesitation in that advance. Basically, crippling Rampage's unidimensional approach. This is just hilarious. Bell rings, but to mess with Rampage, he still lifts him into the air and drops him casually. Look at the way Rampage looks back, like, "I'm gonna write you a stern letter, mister." Safe living. So, how does John do it? Through study. Is there a technique he's using to break down these fighters in his mind before a fight? Yes, there is. It's visualization, or more practically, no, as spatial reasoning. Spatial reasoning is a category of spatial reasoning skills that refers to the capacity to think about objects in three dimensions and draw conclusions about those objects, recording his opponent's behaviors in his mind. I I don't know about Donald Cerrone, as he literally says he doesn't give a damn about studying your opponents at all. But we can all, to some degree, do this in our lives. Not just for a fight, but for job interviews, sitting down, imagining questions, how it will go, how you will sit, how the employer will react. Before we flow into a bit, imagining your general vibe, imagining questions you'll ask, practicing a feint against your opponent to throw a jump shot. This is a skill much more valuable than I believe most people realize, but it's definitely a superpower within all of us. Final note before I wrap this up. John is actually a very insecure person. He's actually quite anxious.
Butterflies in formation. Basically, it means when you have butterflies and you're feeling anxious and you have anxiety and nervous, that's when you're most powerful, I believe. So a lot of people, instead of calming this power, using it, they allow it to just consume them. You know, there's another one that says, a big challenge, a big pressure is like a fire. It's like a raging fire. Either you can allow this fire to consume you, just take you up completely, or you can gain control of this fire and harness it. If you blow it down, you can burn it like Dragon Ball Z style.
But he doesn't let it cripple him by focusing on things he can't control. Instead, he puts it into practical use through study and training. He creates justifications as to why he could possibly lose, trying to make it feel like less of a big deal by partying nonstop a week before a fight. Despite feeling that fragility, he believes, nonetheless, he is the best. He believes he's entitled to win, not because he's arrogant, but instead because he feels the work he put in entitles him to it. Regardless of if you like John or not, this is something we can all use. We can all grow from, regardless of if you're even a fighter. Though he's had a troubled past, but if we focus on the good and try to pull that out, regardless of what you think of him, I hope you may use it to nail your spinning elbow clean and smash your rock of life to pieces. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe if you did. It's good karma. And until next time, peace.
See. Mind Smash. Oh, you gotta watch it. That's on YouTube. Mind Smash.
Lived in harmony, but then the rest is attacked, and only the Avatar skilled in all stunts stopped them. But when he got a fat paycheck, he disappeared. Many years have passed, and the UFC discovered a new Avatar, a Taekwondo bender named Adesanya. Although his Taekwondo skills are great, his Muay Thai, kickboxing, and jiu-jitsu are pretty strong too. Many believe he's just a hype train, but I believe Adesanya could be more than just a John Jones comparison.
That's so crazy. Yeah, goodness.
Hello. Robert Whittaker is a beast. If you're a fan of mixed martial arts, you have to respect the body of work he's accomplished in his division. Not only is he unique with the traditional balance he has in his forward, but he's armed with cantaloupe reflexes and a high fly IQ. As an individual, he's impossible to hate unless you're a sociopath. If you follow the sport, Robert the Reaper Whittaker makes it easy to be a fan, but I found his pre-fight build with Adesanya strange and out of character.
Honestly, I thought I wasn't that impressed.
On that, you mentioned Rob. You know, he's back on his podcast. He said he has a lot of respect for you, but he also believes you're not as good as you think you are.
He was consistently expressing how he was not impressed with Adesanya, how he thought he was an easy fight, and even mocked Adesanya because he got clipped by a head kick from Gaslam. I found this odd because Whittaker said in interviews that if he wanted to take Kelvin seriously,
Kelvin had all my thoughts and focus in the interest on. That's the only guy that I can fight right now. He's the only guy I should be focusing on. He is a tough, young, hungry stud. And if I don't give him the respect he deserves, he's gonna hurt me, man. Kelvin's gonna be one of the hardest fights today. He's very well-rounded, he's young, and he's hungry.
This was all before he was pulled out of his boat with Kelvin Gaston due to medical complications. If he showed Kelvin such respect, why not Israel Adesanya, especially when Rob had said a long-range striker might be his kryptonite? I do not believe Robert was thinking about Israel's skill set correctly, which is why I sent Israel Adesanya this on September 26th, 4:21 p.m. The previous messages weren't sent from me. He's a massive fan of yours, but bro, I believe you're going to win this fight regardless of what anyone else thinks. The moment Rob said, Gaslam landed a head kick, he didn't realize why. It's because Gaslam emphasized his boxing much more than his head kicks throughout his career. He isn't looking at you practically. He's like everyone else who doubted during your career. We all know. I keep going to them time and time again. I really do hate making predictions like this, but man, I truly believe in you. You are a special athlete. You know, I am a fan of Rob's, and I never would have said this if Rob was who he was his entire career. Okay. Word is status by never taking any opponent for granted. With that said, he could have very well won this fight with Israel Adesanya. After all, Whittaker is a beast who must be respected. But as a striker, I don't think it's fair to underestimate one of the best strikers in the world, especially when he's been running through competition with relative ease bar and Gaskell. So, with that said, why did Israel Adesanya win? Thank you for joining me as we take a closer glance. Albert Whittaker was terrified. Every moment he was terrified. The real intent behind his strikes.